Part 4, exercise 2.1. So the question number 4 is, use a variable to write the rule which gives the number of ice candy sticks required to make the following patterns. So a pattern of letter as C, a pattern of letter as M. So what is the problem given here? There is an ice candy stick. So you are using that ice candy stick. So we are going to make some patterns. So pattern means repeated sequence. So for that we have to write the general term or general rules using the variables. So what is the variable? So depend upon the situations, the value is changed. That is the variables. So you have to write the general rule for the given problems. So very first, what is the first pattern? First pattern is a C. So the C can be made with how many sticks? Candy sticks? 3 candy sticks. 1, 2, 3. So if I want to make one C, how many candy sticks are needed? 3 candy sticks are needed. If I want to make 2 C, how many candy sticks is needed? So 3 plus 3. So the 3 is added 2 times. So the answer is 6. If I want to make 3 C, then how many candy sticks are needed? 3 plus 3 plus 3. So 3 is added 3 times. So if I want to make 4 C, then how many candy sticks are needed? 3 plus 3 plus 3 plus 3. So that is 3 is added 4 times. 3 is added again and again. That is 3 is added repeatedly. So that is the repeated addition. So what is the meaning of what is repeated addition? Repeated addition is nothing but it is a multiplication. Using that, how can I write the general terms? The general term can be written as, it is the addition of 3, repeated addition of 3. So that can be written as 3. The general term, I took the variable as n. So it can be written as 3n. So next pattern is an M. For writing the pattern M, how many candy sticks are used? 1, 2, 3 and 4. 4 candy sticks are used. So if I want to make 1 M, 4 candy sticks are used. If I want to make 2M, 4 plus 4, that is 4 is added 2 times. That is 8 candy sticks are used. If I want to make 3M, 4 is added 3 times. If I want to make 4M, 4 is added 4 times. That is 4 is added again and again, repeatedly added. So this is also a multiplications of 4. So the general term can be written as 4 with the variable n. So that is 4n. Next one is question number 5. The teacher forms a group of 5 students in a class. How many students will be there in P groups? So what is the problem given here? The teacher forms a group. If the teacher forms one group, how many students will be there? 5 students will be there. If the teacher forms two group, how many students will be there? 10. That means 5 is added 2 times. If the teacher forms 3 group, then how many students will be there? 15. That is 5 is added 3 times. If the teacher forms 4 group, how many students will be there? 20 students. That is 5 is added 4 times. That is 5 is added again and again repeatedly. So that is 5 with repeatedly means you have to multiply. So 5 with the general term. What is the general term given here? P. So the group is an P. So the answer is an 5P. Next one is question number 6. Arivalagan is 30 years younger to his father. Write Arivalagan's age in term of his father's age. So what is the question given here? So you have to write the Arivalagan's age using his father's age. But in this problem, they don't know what is the father age. But one condition is given that Arivalagan is 30 years younger to his father. That is, Arivalagan is 30 years lesser than the father's age. So lesser means you have to subtract Arivalagan's age from the father age. So very first we have to write what is the father age. So I took the father age as n. Because I don't know the value of age of father, so I took the general term as a n. Then Arivalagan age equal to n minus 30 years. So if the father age is 60, then what is the arrivalian age? 60 minus 30 is 30. So if the father age is 50, so then arrivalian age is 50 minus 30, that is 20. If the father age is 40, then arrivalian age is 40 minus 30, that is 10. So depend upon the situation, the age of the father is changed. So that only here I took the variable as the father's age.